Good morning, children. Children, today we are going to study a chapter, periodic table. But before we start this periodic table chapter, let us see why there was need of preparing this table called periodic table. Actually, what happened by the end of 18th century, when there were more and more elements discovered, it became a little difficult to study those elements individually. So it was thought to classify the elements in a way that the elements with the same properties were put together. With this thinking, the classification was done, and the classification helped in many ways, like it made the study of the elements organized, or you can say it helps in studying the elements in an organized or systematic manner. Classification also helps in correlating the properties of elements with the fundamental properties of all the states of matter. It also helps in defining the relationship between one element and another. Like this, these are the various ways in which the classification can help. Now, earlier, the scientists were classifying elements on the basis of the factors like density, malleability, ductility, metallic nature, non-metallic nature. But the classification on the basis of these factors was not very fruitful. The reason was, when classification was done on the basis of these factors, a large number of elements were falling in each group, and thus the purpose of classification failed. The second problem was that some of the features varied under different conditions. Means these factors, if they were used for classification, they changed or varied in different conditions. So these factors could not be used for classification. Some elements were metallic and non-metallic both. They showed the properties or the characteristics of both metals and non-metals. So again, these factors could not be used for classification. Now, there were certain scientists who thought of preparing some other methods of classification, and among those scientists we'll be studying few. The first scientist who prepared a method of classification in which he made groups of three elements put together and called them as triads, group of three triads. Now, next video we'll be studying about this Dobrynia's triad. The name of the scientist was Dobrynia, and we'll be studying about the Dobrynia's triads method of classifying the elements.